Hi, this video is for Justin of BurnKit 2600. I've been promising to show him the new instrument I've been working on that's based on the original 1-bit groove box. First, let me give you the demo. I've got this plugged into my drum machine over here, so I can trigger individual notes. And I can also use the drum machine sequencer. Then over on the electronic hardware itself, the knobs are hooked up so we can modulate the sound. Now, since I'm encouraging people to be able to build these themselves, I'll show you some of the components that go into it. This is a knob board that I made myself. I'll be posting instructions, a walkthrough on my website for how I did that. And then it connects over these pins to the main board over here, which is the Serb 40 board from GHI Electronics in Michigan. The thing I like about this board is that it's an extremely powerful CPU that they make into a DIP 40 solderable package that you can work with on breadboards like I'm doing here. There's almost nothing else like that out. Then over here, I've got a 6N138 MIDI optocoupler, and that's how I do my MIDI port, just two wires. That goes into one of the many, many serial ports that this device is capable of supporting. And then the other serial port, I've got a 6-pin FTDI debug cable. That's one of the back doors, so you can do all kinds of commands on the CPU. For example, if we look over at the screen for a minute, I can press A, and that gives me a list of all the what the knobs are doing. For example, if I turn them all down, then we should get all zeros. It also gives us some debugging info for what the oscillators are doing in the inside the... Okay, it's not going to make any sound right now. These are what all the variables are doing inside the oscillators. We can use those numbers. And then the other thing that this board has is right here. This is a programming interface called the STM32F4 Discovery Board. This gives you a three-wire debugging interface that lets you interact with the code if necessary at a very, very low level. That's really just for developers. Most instrument builders are probably just going to want to program these things using the USB. Or I encourage people to code as well. Anyway, if you have any more questions about this environment, I'm going to keep developing. Go ahead and just let me know.